the day I gave my life to Jesus. It was around 11:30 a.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time on the 15th of October 1995 after a church service. Now, I hadn't darkened the doorstep of a church for many years, you have to understand. And in this service, the pastor, Ted Keating, preached a message called God is Calling You. It's quite a while ago now, but I remember it as though it were yesterday. It wasn't some wishy-washy thing for me. It wasn't a case of, oh yeah, I guess I believe. No, I was in boots and all. I deliberately, by God's grace, gave my life to Jesus that day. I remember saying to him, God, everything I am, everything I have, every hope and every dream, I give to you. So it was a big deal for me. It was a huge turnaround for me. But for the first year or so, even after that, I was kind of shy about what I'd done. I didn't really want to tell a whole bunch of people about it, to be honest. I'd been a tough, successful businessman, and I was afraid that they'd look at me like a bit of an idiot. I could just hear what people would say. Hey, have you heard? Bernie's got religion. I think he's flipped his lid. When all was said and done, I was ashamed of the gospel. Ashamed, can you believe it? Well, actually, there are plenty of people who believe in Jesus, who even love him, who still today are ashamed of the fact that they've put their trust in him. Think about it. He utterly transforms our lives and still we're ashamed. What's that about? The Apostle Paul was an interesting guy. He too had a dramatic conversion from being a Pharisee who persecuted Christians to a man who, having met Jesus, traveled the whole of the known world telling people about him. This is how Paul puts it, Romans chapter 1, verse 16. I am proud of the good news because it is the power God uses to save everyone who believes, to save the Jews first, and now to save those who aren't Jews. And that attitude got Paul beaten, persecuted, jailed, and ultimately executed. How about you? Are you a closet Christian, or are you like Paul, unafraid to tell others about this Jesus who came to save you? The answer matters. That's God's word. Fresh for you today.